Hello folks, this is Aitin Ancha from InspiredRise.com and today we are going to talk about the Vivo Z1X. It's the latest in Vivo Z series and today I'm going to tell you everything about the same. So guys, let's first start with an unboxing for the same. This is the official box for the Vivo Z1X and there are a lot of things written on the back like the ZAR value and other things about this smartphone. And now let's just take a closer look. The features etc. are written on the back for the smartphone and let's just open it up and see what all do you get inside. So guys, inside the box, the first thing that you get is the TPU curve for the smartphone along with the documentation, the warranty card and few other things like the USB cable. Inside what you get is the smartphone along with the Google Assistant branding, and if you look at the build and design, it feels pretty solid and premium. And at the bottom there's the USB Type-C port, and this smartphone is among the latest in Vivo's lineup of smartphones to ditch the micro USB port. Inside you get the 22.5 watt fast charger for the smartphone along with the Apple AirPods style earphones. The 22.5 watt Vivo flash charge charges the smartphone 50% in just 30 minutes. At the bottom you get the 3.5 mm jack along with the USB Type-C and the speaker grill, and if you look closely it also comes with an in-display fingerprint sensor. On the left hand side there is a dedicated Google Assistant button and the triple SIM slot for this one. Back camera module is slightly protruding out, and if you look closely on the right hand side there is the power button and the volume rocker for the smartphone. The build and design felt pretty sturdy to me, and if you look at the back it's got a very nice gradient finish at the back. It comes in two color options, Fusion Blue and Phantom Purple colors. If I talk about the display, it's a 6.38 inch Super AMOLED Full HD Plus display with 103% NTSC color gamut support. With the 60:1 contrast ratio, I felt that the color reproduction of this display and the sharpness etc. were all on point. The chin is slightly bigger, but the overall design felt good. And if I talk about the in-display fingerprint sensor, it's also pretty fast and accurate. It also supports face unlock, which is really fast, almost instantaneous. The smartphone comes with an always-on display, has a dark mode, Wide One 11 support as well, and the face unlock was so fast that it only took 0.48 seconds. If I talk about the specifications, it comes with a Qualcomm Snapdragon 712 chipset and comes with 6GB LPDDR4X RAM. The UFS 2.1 storage on this one is pretty fast and the battery life is also particularly good. It has a 4500 mAh battery. So just wrap that around your head, 4500 mAh battery, and easily lasts you throughout the day. With the dark mode on, you would get even better battery life. And if I talk about the gaming experience, if you're somebody who's going to play for really long periods of time, you'd appreciate the fact that it has got a huge battery, and the Snapdragon 712 enables you to play games like PUBG with HD and high settings, and you can play those games for a really long duration of time. This smartphone comes with a lot of multi-turbo modes like the Center Turbo, AI Turbo, Net Turbo, Cooling Turbo and the Game Turbo mode, and it didn't heat up much even during extended periods of gameplay. The benchmark scores are also good enough, and it also comes with a game countdown feature which allows you to save your time while waiting for PUBG to start. And particularly I like the fact that this smartphone packs in so much at such a great price, and it's one of the worthy successors to the Vivo Z1 Pro, which was a great smartphone at its price point. Talking about the camera, it comes with a 48 megapixel AI rear triple camera setup, IMX582 sensor with a f/1.79 aperture, 120 degree super wide angle and one depth sensor. The 32 megapixel front camera is also no slouch and takes really great photographs. Vivo has certainly upped their image quality game with the latest algorithms, and I found that the selfie camera is one of the best in class. No other smartphones below 20k takes as great selfies as this smartphone, and I like the color science, details, reproduction, everything else on this smartphone. In terms of video quality, it was okay, but I felt that the video quality could certainly have been slightly better, but in terms of stills, it's one of the better smartphone cameras out there. This device also comes with low brightness anti-flicker, which is almost like DC dimming, and it also has infrared sensor, a lot of good things on it. And now let's do a sound check. The sound was not really extremely loud, but it was good enough for your normal day-to-day usage. And if we talk about the pricing and the different variants available for the smartphone, it's one of the nicely priced smartphones at a price of around 16,990 for the 6GB, 64GB and 18,990 for the 6GB, 128GB variant. And all of these launch offers, I believe that the Vivo Z1X packs in a lot of features at this particular price point. And if you're somebody out there going to buy a smartphone below 20k, this is one of the more compelling options out there until new smartphones by Vivo or some other company don't launch. Right now, it competes against the Realme X and few other smartphones, and it does beat them in terms of the battery life, camera quality, and few other things. And at the end of the day, it's all your choice what kind of smartphone you want to buy. So guys, this was it for this video. In case you like this one, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button and do subscribe to Inspire to Rise for more awesome tech videos like this one. And guys, no matter what you do, stay inspired to rise.